In this video, we are going to see about types of pressure gauge and its working principle. What is pressure gauge? Pressure gauges are instruments used for pressure measurement. Pressure gauges uses pressure sensing elements for measuring applied pressure. The pressure sensing elements deforms elastically under pressure, which helps in measurement. Types of pressure gauge. There are different types of pressure gauges available. Pressure gauges are divided into three types based on pressure sensing elements. They are Bourdon tube, diaphragm, and bellow. Bourdon tube type pressure gauge. Bourdon tubes are circular shaped tubes with an oval cross section. Bourdon tubes are manufactured in three different forms. They are C type, spiral type, and helical type. Bourdon tubes sensing element used for the measurements of medium to high pressures. Without pressure, the circular cross section of the Bourdon tube is flattened. When these elements are pressurized, their cross section tends to become more circular, which tends to straighten their shape. C-type Bourdon sensor. The circular cross section of the Bourdon tube is flattened. C-type Bourdon tube usually have an arc of 270 degrees. The process pressure is connected to the tube support end of the tube, while the tip end is sealed. When pressure is applied, the tube is tend to straighten. The resulting tip motion is non-linear. This non-linear motion is getting converted into linear rotational pointer motion, mechanically, by means of a geared sector and pinion movement through connecting link. C-type Bourdon elements can be used for positive, negative, or compound pressure ranges, but the indication on the vacuum side will not be accurate or sensitive. C-type Bourdon elements are available with spans from 0 to 15 psi to 0 to 20,000 psi. Spiral-type Bourdon sensor. Since the free end motion of the C-type Bourdon tube is insufficient in some cases, spiral-type Bourdon tube is used. The spiral element is essentially a series of C-type Bourdon tubes joined end to end. When pressure is applied, this flat spiral tends to uncoil and produces a greater movement of the free end, requiring no mechanical amplification. This increases the sensitivity and accuracy of the instrument because no lost motion or friction is introduced through the links and levers. Spans as low as 10 psi are available for positive, negative, or compound ranges. Helical Bourdon pressure sensor. This sensor produces an even greater motion of the free end than the spiral element, eliminating the need for mechanical amplification. The range of the helical coil is affected by the diameter, wall thickness, number of coils used, and construction materials. High pressure elements might have as many as 20 coils, while low span sensors can have only 2 or 3 coils. Helical elements are available with spans from 0 to 30 psi to 0 to 80,000 psi. Other advantages of this design include, the high overrange protection is available. For example, A 0 to 1000 psi element may be safely exposed to 10,000 psi pressure, and it is suitable for pressure measurement on continuously fluctuating surfaces. Diaphragm type pressure gauge. Diaphragm elements are circular shaped, corrugated membranes. When pressure is applied, the diaphragm membrane elongates. The diaphragm is mechanically connected to the transmission mechanism, which will amplify the small deflections of the diaphragm and transfer them to the pointer. In comparison with Bourdon tubes, these diaphragm elements have a relatively high actuating force and they are insensitive to vibration. The diaphragm element can be subject to higher overload. Used for measurements with highly viscous, impure, or crystallizing process media. Pressure ranges can be between 0 to 16 millibar and 0 to 40 bar, with accuracy classes from 0.6 to 2.5. Capsule. The diaphragm is a single sheet, joining two diaphragm to form a capsule. The sensing element of a capsule pressure gauge consists of two corrugated diaphragms welded together at their periphery to form a capsule. The pressure to be measured is introduced into the capsule via an opening in the center of the first diaphragm. The center of the second diaphragm is connected to the transmission mechanism so that the deflection of the measuring element can be transmitted to the pointer. Pressure ranges can be between 0 to 2.5 millibar and 0 to 0.6 bar, with accuracy classes of 0.1 to 2.5. Bellows type pressure gauge. Bellows type sensing elements are for low to intermediate pressures. They are used in vacuum, absolute, and differential pressure measurement applications. The bellows expands or contracts based on the pressure difference across the inside and outside of the bellows unit. Four basic designs of bellows pressure detectors will be discussed. They are classified by the reference pressure used as absolute, gauge, or differential pressure detectors. Absolute gauge, using bellows sensor. When absolute pressure is to be sensed with bellows elements, it normally involves two bellows. Out of two bellows, one for measuring, and the other for reference. The reference bellow element is fully evacuated and sealed, while the sensing element is connected to the process. The pressure of the media to be measured is compared against a reference pressure, which is equal to absolute zero. In this arrangement, an increase in process pressure will cause the measuring bellows to extend, which results in an increase of readout through the motion balance mechanism. If the process pressure is constant but the barometric pressure changes, force will be exerted equally on the outside of both bellows, causing no change in the readout. The evacuated bellows are capable of compensating for barometric pressure variations as high as 100 mm of mercury. When bellows are used as the pressure sensing element, it is desirable to add a spring for ranging and accurate characterization. Without the calibration spring, temperature effects and work hardening of the bellows would cause a loss of accuracy. When relatively low pressures need to be measured, the process pressure is introduced into the inside of the bellows. For higher pressures, the outside surface of the bellows is exposed to the process pressure. Differential pressure gauges, using dual bellows. Dual bellows elements are also available as differential pressure sensors. Two sealed pressure media chambers are separated by the measuring elements. If both operating pressures are the same, no movement of the measuring element occurs and no pressure will be indicated. When one of the pressures is either higher or lower than the other, a differential pressure reading will be indicated. If either the low or the high pressure side is left open to the atmosphere, the unit will detect either gauge pressure or vacuum pressure. With diaphragm elements, a very high overload capability is achieved. Pressure ranges can be between 0 to 16 millibar and 0 to 40 bar, with accuracy classes of 0.6 to 2.5.
Thank you for watching this video. For more videos like this, please subscribe to Simple Science.